understand what we are all about. And that's when you die to self. You're not standing in that park or standing there watching people go by, desiring to have what they have. Being feeling good because you're not like them. And doing all of this nonsensical human side of you where there is no wealth. You see, where there is no treasure, where there is only you, and that is something that is going to lead you down always, makes you weak, really weak. But if you want to be strong, then you become the other. You serve the others. You are leading your heart to let everybody be first in every way, in every possible way. And you're going to transform your life. Because then you're going to stop whining. It's not anymore about you. It's not anymore about the little you. Why are we so depressed? Why are we confused? Why are we lonely? Why are we desperate? Why are we weak? And why don't we have compassion and mercy and forgiveness? Because we are too much of ourselves. We are too big of a person. So we are offended very easily. We lose hope very easily because we are too big, we're too important. We made a big deal out of our lives, and then our lives get too complicated very easy. And anybody can take our peace away because we give power to everybody. And everybody can change our ideas anytime. I'm going this direction. And somebody comes up with a strong opinion or some great imaginary of whatever I'm not even looking for, and they take me away somewhere else. I'm changing directions all the time, going with the stronger, going with the toughest wind. What kind of life is that? That is a miserable life, and that's not the life that God gave us. God gave us a spirit of joy and a sense of direction. He laid down the path, the perfect path, for us to walk on a path that for sure is leading us home. And no one can confuse us. That's why the Lord says, my sheep know my voice. They hear my voice and they follow me. They understand that it's me talking to them. No thief can come in and speak to them and mislead them because they know my voice. But we have to know how to learn his voice. We have to find out how to get close to his voice and understand that. You know that a child that is being led by the mother's hand through a crowd and all of a sudden accidentally loses grip of the hand of the mother and fuses into the crowd, and then if that child hears the mother's voice in the midst of a million voices, that child knows that's mom's voice, you know. It's going to go towards the voice because he's hearing it. And he distinguishes that voice in the midst of voices, hundreds of them. That's mom's voice. And that's supposed to be God's voice in our hearts. We're supposed to distinguish God's voice. But what do we have to do in order to distinguish God's voice in our hearts? We have to be that child with mom, that child with dad. We have to love dad. We have to be so close to dad that even if you lose grip of his hand, we still hear his voice and we can go towards him and find his hand again. And that's what we have to do. Walk tight with the hand of the Father and walk with him, with the hand of the Master. And for that, we have to be faithful to that voice, faithful to that teaching, faithful to that path, faithful to that truth so that we can have life. And that is the truth of our Christian life. So for that to be possible in our lives, we have to die to self. That's very important. To stop building ourselves more. And you see, we live the dangers of this world's psychologies, the dangers of this world's ideologies and philosophies. And today, this is the season of the fables. Like St. Paul says, there's going to come a time when they're going to come from everywhere. And fables are going to take a lot of you away. Even believers are going to be fooled. And you see, so much going on today that is misleading people. And they talk in beautiful things. They speak in a glamorous language, very polished language. A language that is manicured and well presented, so articulate. And some of them hold great credentials. But what good does it do when those credentials are not giving you light? They are not solving your depressions and your fears and your doubts and anxieties. They even make you more ambitious for nothing, chasing the wind, following goals of this world that are never going to make you happy for real, are never going to give you joy or peace or freedom for that matter. Now, today we have the greatest opportunity. We are here gathering together as one people, people of God, and God as one comes and gives us this incredible river of wisdom to our hearts so that we can wake up, so that we can really wake up and say, what am I doing with my life? I'm worshiping self, and I'm worshiping people, and I'm worshiping people's ideas, and I'm worshiping the world's philosophies, and the thing I never done is to worship God because I'm pretending to be when I'm not. And that is the beginning of a true faith. A true faith will never be established in your heart until you let go of this great edifice you are building. Sometimes you see people walk in into your life and you see a giant there. You are concerned because you might offend them. You're concerned about the words you're going to use because they might not like them. You are concerned about what they think about you. You might not get a chance with them and things like that because they are gigantic persons. They are persons that intimidate you because they are buildings of pride, buildings of pretentiousness and vanity. And that's the most common human building in this world. Let's not be one of those buildings. They are ugly. They're never going to see the face of God. They are not walking home. We're supposed to be that building of humbleness, that building of humility. There is nothing more precious in this life than to see a humble human being, a person that will not treat you, a person that will not intimidate you, a person that do not bring this great building of personality in front of you, a person that brings that love and tenderness to your life, that understands you, that feels for you, that will give you a hand anytime. That's beautiful, because that is Christ among us. And we have to become a Christ like that. We have to become a love like that. We have to become a compassion like that, a humility like that. What a waste to be proudful. What a waste to be smart and go and have the answer for everything and try to top everybody's stories. Try to be ahead of everyone, compete with everyone to be ahead of everyone, to impress everyone. And always trying to get the prize, always trying to make it to the first place. What a disaster. That doesn't bring anything good, you know. We are living in a world of false heroes. Heroes on the left, heroes on the right, and everybody's wearing their t-shirts and everything. Heroes here and heroes there. False heroes. They don't bring anything good to your heart. We are not to worship heroes. We have only one hero, and that hero is called Jesus. That is the hero. The hero, the only one that conquered death. You see, all the heroes of this world, you will see them processing to the cemetery, one after another. They're all buried. Where are the heroes of yesterday? They're all dead. So, they weren't heroes. For you to be a hero, you have to be eternal. That's a hero. And Jesus is the hero, because he conquered what no hero has ever conquered. He conquered death. Show me one like that. Show me one. And I will wear the t-shirt, yes. I will. But it's not like that. So let's wear the t-shirts of the hero, the real hero. Let's wear the flags, unfold the flag of the hero, the real hero, the one that conquered death. That's the one I want to follow. That is my hero. I want to follow a true, a real hero. And the only real hero I know is Jesus, because he is the only one that died, was crucified, I mean in a horrifying way, and then he resurrected. Imagine how big that is. No one has done that. Nobody has done that. Nobody can do that. That is my hero. That is my real hero. But for me to understand this heroic life of Jesus, I have to have a desire in my heart to imitate my hero. What are heroes? Those that we imitate and we want to be like them. That's why they are our heroes, because we want to be like them. Today's heroes are false, are like plastic. What do they have? Money, they have fame, and they have vices. Lots of vices, because they are very famous for their decadence, most of them, right? And then they make a cult to their decadence. And those are the heroes of today. Most of them are just filled with all kinds of the wrong things. And now, not all of them are like that, but those heroes I'm talking about are not the heroes we are to worship. We are to worship the hero, Jesus. But for that, we have to understand how